Cardarine, also known as GW501516, is an interesting experimental research drug. It is derived from a class of metabolic agents known as peroxisome, proliferative activated receptor delta agonist. It is not a SARM. Cardarine was developed by a co-venture of two large biotech pharmaceutical companies, Ligon Pharmaceuticals and GlaxoSmithKline, in 1992. They were looking for an agent to improve cardiovascular disease. Cardarine showed positive results in improving lipid abnormalities. It increased HDL by up to 17% and lowered LDL by 7% in one study. In addition, lipid particle size was improved that may have led to further cardiovascular protection. Unfortunately, in 2009, Cardarine was pulled from further research as it led to widespread cancer in long-term preclinical animal studies. Since this time, Cardarine has not been studied further as a medical therapeutic agent. Subsequently, and with the growth of the internet and explosion of the peptide sites, Cardarine has been widely used by the fitness world. Cardarine is thought to be an exercise mimetic, with subsequent activation of mitochondrial biogenesis in skeletal muscle tissue that can lead to remodeling of the muscle tissue itself. In mice studies, Cardarine caused fast twitch muscle fibers to convert to slow twitch muscle fibers. That's amazing. Additionally, it may cause a shift in energy metabolism, reducing glucose metabolism and increasing a reliance on free fatty acid mobilization and oxidation. These metabolic adaptations would benefit the endurance athlete. I've always wondered about this and the utility on muscle building and strength athletes. I'd like to hear from you guys. Let's hear some anecdotes, your experiences with this agent. Is it anabolic? Does it really improve your fitness? Did you gain lean muscle? Were there any side effects? That's very important. How much did you use? What are the doses and for how long? And lastly, would you keep using this agent with its potential for causing cancer? There's been a lot of controversy on Cardarine due to its effectivity on helping people metabolically, and yet with the concerns of being a carcinogenic agent. What do you guys think? Is this agent really effective metabolically? And if so, is the cancer risk real? Is it worth it? Is there really a conspiracy on this agent, keeping it from being used? Or are the risks just not worth it?